What's up, trade hackers? Welcome to today's Trade Hacker update. Today's Thursday, July 9th. Before we jump into the charts, just want to make you aware of a new private Facebook group that we've got going on for our new day trading options for income. We've got a course coming out here soon. By the way, I've got a date for you. August 6th, that is a Thursday. Don't have all the details yet, but it's going to be kind of a late afternoon central time on August 6th is when we will be presenting our new day trading options for income course. So look for more details in the weeks to come. I know a lot of people are anticipating that, so glad to have something kind of on the books, but so just kind of earmark that date and we'll follow up with more details. You can't miss it. We'll make sure we let you know. But if you want to kind of follow along on what we're doing, posting, we're doing it here in this private Facebook group. We've opened this up to a few of our pro members, but feel free to join now. It's facebook.com/groups/NavigationTrading, or just go to Facebook and search for day trading options for income or search for Navigation Trading. You'll find it. And go ahead and join. This is where we post, just to give you kind of a quick update. Like today, for example, did a few trades, did a pairs trade between NASDAQ and the Dow, booked about almost a $700 profit on that early morning, and then had three other of our kind of our main day trading strategy, 3 for 3, just small positions, BABA, Microsoft, NVIDIA, booked a total of a little over $1,100 yesterday, actually about $2,200. So shaping up to be a good little week. Hopefully I don't F things up tomorrow and spoil it all. I've been known to do that, but it should be a decent week of trading on the day trading front. So if you want to follow along, again, facebook.com/groups/NavigationTrading. Check that out and look for that August 6th announcement for the new day trading course. Exciting stuff. Can't wait to share it with you guys. Let's go to the platform, take a look. Weird day of trading today overall. I mean, this is just a 5-minute chart of the VIX. Now, I was looking at the VIX this morning when we had this big red bar, and I don't know if it was just kind of a quick anomaly, but the VIX at one point was down 6%, whereas the VIX futures were only down about 0.5%. And then I thought, okay, maybe that was just a kind of a quirky, you know, price pre-market kind of a deal. But then, you know, we had a huge sell-off. Let's go to the ES. Let's go to the S&P. So we started out the day pretty flat. All the broad markets were pretty flat. And then we had this huge sell-off in the morning. And the Russell led the way selling off. Then the Dow and the S&P followed. The NASDAQ was still holding on to pretty close to even. And then all of a sudden it started to sell off. So I thought, okay, maybe we'll get a little bit of follow through. And as soon as that happened, boom, we bounced back higher. And even though volatility, I mean, you see the VIX futures are up, volatility is up, the VIX, the spot VIX is up 2%. I mean, volatility kind of got crushed. I mean, the VIX was up, you know, like I said, closer to 6. VIX futures were up, you know, up above 2% on the day. And on this rally, I mean, things really just got crushed. In fact, we've got a couple weekly double calendars, one of our strategies on, and we ended up just closing one out for a small profit. But I mean, even with volatility up, the differential between the front and back week, just volatility is acting really weird. So what do I take from that? Well, there's nothing that I really take from, you know, is the market going to go down or up or anything like that. But just really interesting, anytime you see some kind of inefficiencies like that, not inefficiencies, some weird, quirky things like that, it always makes you pause and wonder if there is something bigger going on. Because a lot of times when we do see some volatility coming, it is preceded by some quirkiness in the way that volatility is reacting to the overall market. So let's just go to a daily chart. So this is the S&P. And you know, I mean, obviously you see it here on the daily bar here, you know, just big sell-off and then rally back. Now the S&P is only down 15. It was down close to 50 at one point. And, you know, Russell's still down 1.5%, but now the NASDAQ's up almost 1%. Dow's down about 1.25%. So big turnaround in stocks. You know, I mean, that was just a little blip on the S&P anyway. So, you know, nothing broken to the downside by any means. NASDAQ, obviously, it didn't even break yesterday's low and continued higher. The Russell a little bit weaker, but still, you know, just basically been trading flat for the last couple of weeks and with some violent swings back and forth, but overall in a pretty narrow box there. Oil down a few percent, gold down a little bit, bonds up a pretty decent amount, natty gas down. So some decent swings in the market. You know, one thing that I did notice when the overall markets were well down is that, well, A, the NASDAQ was still up, but in a lot of the big names, I mean, your Amazons, your big tech companies, they were all still positive. And some were trading near all-time highs. And so, you know, I didn't really buy the downside until the NASDAQ really started to sell off. And then I thought, well, we may have some follow through, but you cannot keep the NASDAQ down. It is super strong. And so it just rallied. And I mean, look at AMD up 7%, Amazon up another 3.5%. I mean, Amazon, what a crazy, crazy move. Big stock making just gargantuan moves, hitting all-time highs again right now. It's 2:20. We've got about 40 minutes left in the cash market. BABA up another 1.5%. So tech just having a heyday. If you look at Roku up 11%. I mean, even when the rest of the market was just coming down, Roku was still up like 7%. Now it's up 11%. So just some crazy stuff. Shopify up 3%. But on the other side, you've got these other stocks. I mean, you got Schlumberger down 4%. You've got Intapp down 2%. Morgan Stanley down over 2%. So the banks getting hit to the downside, but tech just pushing this thing higher. Let's see if there's any other big movers. Boeing, you know, down 3.5%. So really just a mixed bag where tech is up, a lot of other things down. So kind of a crazy day of trading, which when it comes to day trading is a good thing. You want that volatility, you want that two-sided action. And then, you know, for the other positions, it's fine as well. But so that's what's going on in the markets. That's all I got for you today. Everybody have a great evening. Again, if you want to check out the more on the day trading stuff, join our Facebook group. Just search Navigation Trading or Day Trading Options for Income on Facebook. Check that out. Join, follow along. We post every day kind of what's going on. And then the class coming August 6th. Look forward to it. Everybody have a great evening. Talk to you later. See ya.